Good morning children, I am English teacher. Today we are going to do chapter number 4 of Beehive, A Truly Beautiful Mind. This lesson is a biography of Albert Einstein, where the narrator has traced his life in a nutshell from the time of his birth to education and later to his obsession with science and the theory of relativity, which made him famous all over the world. Albert Einstein was born on 14th March in Germany. He was a late talker, and when he did start, he would repeat each utterance twice. His friends found his company boring, and so no one wanted to play with him. He started playing on his own. His best toys were mechanical toys. When he was taken to school, his headmaster predicted that he would not be successful in life, but he was wrong. Albert was good at studies and also in music. He learned to play the violin at the age of 6. Albert did not like the school at Munich because of its strict discipline and rules. Albert could not accept such a condition where he could not express his ideas or perspective. He would often confront his teachers and as a result became very unpopular. He therefore decided to leave the school. He completed his school in Switzerland and later joined the University of Zurich, where he fell in love with a Serb called Mileva Maric. In her, he found an ideal companion. She was more of an intellectual and social ally. He wanted to marry her immediately after completing his studies, but his mother refused to approve of this marriage. Albert gave up the idea of marrying her for some time, but he did marry her later on. For almost 2 years after completing his education, Albert did not get any job, so he took up a teaching assistant's job. After 2 years, he got a job in Bern in an office where patents were assessed. Albert started working, but at the same time, he used his free time to develop his own theory on gravitation and relativity. He would safely keep his papers in a drawer, which he lovingly called the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. After some time, his marriage seemed to be having trouble, and he finally divorced Mileva and married his own cousin, Elsa. During this time, his general theory of relativity got published and received wide acclaim. Albert had calculated the deflection in the light coming from fixed stars on a solar eclipse day due to the sun's gravity. In 1919, there was a solar eclipse and his calculations were tested. He was proved to be right. After a few years, with the coming of Nazi into power in 1933, Albert left Germany and settled in America. During this time, Germany was becoming very powerful. The scientists there had discovered the technique of making an atom bomb. When this news reached the American scientists, they were very upset. Albert could visualize what this meant. He wrote a letter to the President of America, Franklin D. Roosevelt, highlighting the danger to world security. The president took the warning seriously and allowed his scientists to work on this project of producing an atom bomb secretly. The atom bomb was produced eventually and dropped over two Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1945. The devastation caused by the bombs shocked Einstein. He was so moved that he wrote a letter to the United Nations proposing the formation of a world government so that countries did not go to war. But his suggestion was not heeded to. This motivated him to join politics so that he could agitate and protest. He knew that he had become a world figure and was very popular, and so his voice would be heard. He had won many awards, including the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921. He died in 1955 at the age of 76. People paid homage to him as a world citizen, a visionary, and a scientific genius. Thank you, children. Thank you.